So I'm wondering, how much time have you invested in reading, studying, and memorizing the Word of God this week? I ask myself the question quite often. You know, as a pastor, I have to study to prepare to write sermons. That's my job. But that's not really my devotion. My devotion must be personal. Outside of preparing to study the Bible to preach, how much time do I study just to be with God and to be in His presence and to hear from Him and to experience Him? Did you know that the latest surveys tell us that only 9% of Americans read the Bible four times a week? Only 9%. 80% of Americans claim to be a Christian, but only 9% read the Bible as much as four times a week. Surveys also tell us that 35% of Americans haven't ever read a Bible. I mean, think about that. Living in our nation where there's a church on every corner, where you have Christian materials so readily available, we have Christian radio and Christian television, and 35% of Americans claim they have never read the Bible at all. Now, here's the interesting thing. Surveys also tell us that people who read the Bible on a regular basis are much more likely to not lie, or steal, or cheat, or commit adultery. Doesn't say they won't do it, they're just much more not likely to do it. It's also something else I discovered as I was researching this. People who read the Bible on a regular basis claim that they don't experience loneliness like the general public. Think about that. Time in God's Word fills you with a sense of His presence and helps us to battle the loneliness that we can experience in our postmodern world where everybody's on their phones but nobody's involved in a conversation. So you could easily say that the more time you spend in God's Word, the more you experience His presence through His Word, the better off your life will be. I mean, that just really goes without saying. We proclaim that, but now we have science that literally backs it up. So again, I come back and I ask you, how much time did you invest this week in reading, studying, and memorizing the Word of God? How much does it come up in your conversations? See, I find myself too often discussing the Bible only as a means of correcting somebody's misuse of the Bible. But we need to have conversations, ongoing conversations with people, where we just share with them, hey, God spoke to me this morning. I was reading the Word and this verse just leapt off the page at me. The other day I was having my devotion time and I came across this psalm and I've read it many, many times, but all of a sudden it just resonated with my heart. It just filled me with a sense of joy and a sense of purpose that I've never known before. We need to be having those kinds of conversations on a regular basis as we seek God's kingdom first and foremost. And as we are filled with God's Holy Spirit, His Word is going to become alive to us, and it's going to flow in us as we read it and flow out of us as we discuss it. I recently read about a critic who stood up at a meeting one night, and he wanted to explain his disdain for the Bible. In doing so, he used this example. He said, you know, I grew up having to go to church. My parents drugged me to church. And in the time of going to church with my parents, I bet I heard 1,000 sermons. But in that time, I can't tell you one sermon I remember. I don't remember one passage the preacher preached on. I don't remember one point that he used. I don't even remember any of his illustrations. What good did it do me to go to church and hear sermons from the Bible? A Bible scholar who's in that same meeting stood up and said, sir, I've got an answer for you, and here's the answer. In my married life, my wife has prepared 1,000 meals for me, probably. In the years we've been married, she has fixed breakfast, lunch, and dinner many, many times. I don't remember any one specific meal. I can't tell you the ingredients that she used. But I know those meals nourished me and enabled me to do my job. They kept me healthy and strong. Without my wife and our meals, I would be a much different man. And the same is true for the Bible. We may not remember one encounter, but if we spend time with it every day, we invest in time in God's Word every day, if we wrestle with those passages that convict us and correct us every day, if we have those godly conversations with other people about the Word of God every day, then over time, the consistency of the Word of God will transform us, make us more like Jesus. We need to invest daily in time in God's Word. Now, let me invite you to join with your life group and discuss this subject. What does the Word of God mean to you? How has it spoken to you? What truths have you learned from the Word of God? What was the last conversation you had about the Bible? How do you feast daily on God's Word? What are your favorite passages? What was the last time that the Bible corrected you, reproved you, rebuked you? Discuss that with your group. This should be a really interesting conversation.